Welcome to Microprocessor and Interfacing playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining Programmable Peripheral Interface IC8255. And to explain this, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain basics of 8255. Then I'll explain control signals in 8255. Then I'll explain block diagram of 8255. Then I'll explain control word of 8255, and then at the end we will see modes of operation in 8255. So see, basically 8255, that is programmable peripheral interface IC, and that is what we are utilizing to increase input output interfacing capability of basic level microprocessor. Like, see, initially with 8085 microprocessor, Intel was facing difficulty in terms of input output interfacing capability. The reason is there were limited address and data buses, so we cannot have more interfacing with basic level microprocessor. And to increase its capability of interfacing, 8255 IC that have introduced, which have increased interfacing capacity. So let us initiate this session with basics of 8255. See, 8255, programmable peripheral interface IC, that has been designed to increase input output interfacing capability of microprocessor. It has 24 input output pins that can be grouped into two 8 bits parallel ports, like port A and port B, and the remaining 8 bits that is there with port C. Port C can be used as individual bits and can be used as a group of 4 bits with upper group of C and lower group of C. So ultimately in 8255 there are 3 ports: port A, port B and port C. Port A and port B that can be used directly as parallel ports, and port C that can be used as individual bits. And port C can be grouped further in upper C group and lower C group. 8255 functions in following modes. It functions in two different modes: input output mode and BSR mode. In input output mode, there are another 3 modes, like mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2. And in bits, BSR means bit set reset mode. So these modes that I'll be explaining in detail in this session, at the end of this session, so stay tuned with this video. You will be finding how these modes are functioning, so it is little more interesting. Now see, next part of this session, that is control signals in 8255. So when you see the IC of 8255, it has this control signals, so which is so essential. Read bar signal, so that is active low signal, and that is been forwarded by microprocessor to read data from any of selected port. So when microprocessor sends read bar data, means active low signal on this terminal, microprocessor wants to read data from the selected port. Write bar signal, that is even active low signal, that is been forwarded by microprocessor to write data on selected port. Reset signal, that is active high signal, it will clear all control register and it will set all ports as input mode. So ultimately, when you reset 8255, it will clear control register and you will be finding all ports are functioning in input mode. And there are 3 more control signals, like chip select. If it is active low, then we will be selecting 8255 chip. If it is 1, then we cannot select 8255 chip. And regarding A0 and A1, if A0 A1 is 00, we will be selecting port A. If it is 01, we will be selecting port B. If it is 10, we will be selecting port C, and if it is 11, we will be selecting control register. And by selecting control register, we can set modes of operation of 8255. So we will see that in next part of this session. But first of all, we should understand if A0 and A1, that is 00, it means port A is getting selected 01, port B 10, port C if it is 11, then control register is getting selected. And if chip select, that is 1, means 8255 is not selected. So it is so essential to have chip select is equals to 0 to select this chip. So let us see all those things in block diagram. So we can see block diagram of 8255 here. Now see, we can bisect this block diagram in two groups, group A and group B. This group A, that is being connected with port A and upper group of port C, and group B, that is connected with port B and lower group of port C. So port B, that is there with terminal PB0 to PB7. Port A, that is there with terminal PA0 to PA7. Lower group of port C, that is there with PC0 to PC3. And upper group of port C, that is there from PC4 to PC7. So there are total three ports, port A, port B and port C. Port C is further divided into two parts, upper port C and lower port C. Lower port C is having terminal PC0 to PC3. Upper port C is having terminals PC4 to PC7. So ultimately group A is having port A and upper port C, and group B, that is having control of port B and lower port C. And this is what we are connecting it with data transfer D0 to D7 and control signals read bar, write bar, A0, A1 and reset and chip select. So we have already discussed working of these terminals, like read bar signal, that is to read data from selected port, write bar, that is to write data from selected port, A0 and A1, that is to select port A, port B and port C. If it is 00, port A is getting selected, 01, port B is getting selected, 10, port C is getting selected, and if it is 11, then control word is getting selected, and in controlled word, we will have to place data on D0 to D7 and as A0 and A1, that is 11, will be having control word over here. So in control word, we'll be defining what type of mode of operation is happening right now with 8255. And based on that, we can understand how this IC is functioning. And in reset, it is active high signal. If it has been given to reset with 8255, all ports will function as input port and it will clear this control register. So this is what the basic block diagram which is there with 8255. Now let us have control word of 8255. So see, in control word of 8255, we have D7, D6, D5, D4, D3, D2, D1 and D0. That many bits are there. First bit, D7 bit. So that will define input, output and BSR mode. If it is 1, then 8255 will function in input, output mode. If it is 0, then 8255 will function in BSR, means bit, set, reset mode. So this bit, D7, that will define input output or BSR. If it is 1, then input output, and if it is 0, then BSR mode, that will get activated. Now, as I have explained you, this IC can be bisected into two groups, group A and group B. Now see, in group A, this D5 and D6, that will define mode of operation. 00 will select mode 0, 01 will select mode 1, and 1x means 1 don't care, that will select mode 2. And this is what we are selecting it in input output mode. The reason is, I have already told, like there are two types of modes, either input output mode, either BSR mode. So in input output modes, there are three modes, mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2. And in BSR mode, it is bit, set, reset mode. We will see that in detail. So if microprocessor is controlling 8255 with input output mode by placing D7 is equals to 1, then this group A that can have mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2 by selecting D5 and D6. So if D5 and D6, that is 00 mode 0, 01 mode 1, 1x mode 2 will get selected. And this D4 bit that is connected with port A, if it is 1, port A will function as input. If it is 0, port A will function as output. And this D3 of group A that is connected with upper port of C, which will be having 1 is equals to input upper port, 0 is equals to output of C upper port. For group B control, this D2 bit that will select mode, if it is 0, then mode 0 will get selected. If it is 1, then mode 1 will get selected. So in group B, we cannot have mode 2. In group E, input output mode, there are only two modes, mode 0 and mode 1. 0 will result into mode 0 and 1 will result into mode 1. This D1 bit that is selecting port B as input as if it is 1, and if it is 0, then it will get selected with output port. So port B will be output in case of 0 and 1 will result into input port. And this D0 that will make C lower port as input port if it is 1, and if it is 0, then it will be output port. So this is what about control word of 8255. Now let us try to understand how many modes are there. So see, as I have told, this D7 bit that will make BSR mode. So if it is 0, then we can say 8255, that is there in BSR mode. Now where in BSR means beat set reset mode. So what we will be doing is we will be setting port C as beat set reset mode. Now see how this D1, D2, D3 that will select bit. So if it is 0, 0, 0, it will select first bit, means 0th bit. If it is 0, 0, 1, it will be selecting first bit. If it is 0, 1, 0, it will be selecting second bit. If it is 0, 1, 1, it will be selecting third bit. Likewise, if it is 1, 1, 1, it will be selecting 7th bit of port C. So, any bit of port C that will get selected by using D1, D2 and D3. This D4, D5 and D6 that is unused. Now, to set particular bit at D0, if it is 1, then it will get set, and if it is 0, then that bit will get reset. So port C that will get set and reset by using BSR mode. And in input output mode, I have already told there are three different modes: mode 0, mode 1 and mode 2. In mode 0, all ports will function as simple input output mode. In mode 1, port A and or port B will work as input output mode, and port C that will work as handshaking. In mode 2, port A will function as bidirectional data bus, port B that will function as simple input output, and port C that will function as handshaking. Port B will function as mode 0 or mode 1, means it will function as input output mode. So in mode 2, port A will function as bidirectional data, port B will function as input output, and port C that will function as handshaking. So this is how modes are defined, and to select that mode, I have already explained control word. By using that, we can easily understand how we can use mode, how to work out with mode. I hope that by this session, you have understood this IC 8255. If you have any query, you just write down in comments. Definitely I'll try to resolve all those queries which you are placing here. And in future, I'll make videos based on your suggestion. So please give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll place videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.